Hello everyone. Hello everyone. Can you hear me? Hello Laura, hello everyone. Thank you all for being here. Today we're going to do a skin tone tutorial. But we're going to use lots of colors, not just the normal skin tones. Okay, so let's start. The first color I'm using is Chart Reuse. I think I pronounced it correctly. It's a PC989. It's a green color. We're going to add the color on the face. And yes, it looks crazy, like I'm coloring an alien. But it will give the skin tones a warmer tone, almost like the skin is glowing. Hello everyone. Happy Tuesday to you too. Okay, so now I've basically covered the whole face except the nose. And the eye areas here and the lips. Hi Rebel, thank you so much. The next up is Deco Yellow. The Deco Yellow, we're going to put on the highlighted areas. Hi, Kaz. Great to see you here. Next is cream, PC914. This page is from Faces 4. The page is called Shona. I think if she's not a single page, then she would be part of the 5-page set. And here we highlight the top of the lips. And I've decided to let the sun, the lighter area on the face, come from this side. But I wanted light reflection from the left-hand side bottom as well. You must always concentrate on where the light falls on the face to where the shadow areas will be. If you want to darken, for example, on this side more, you can get more dramatic effect on your portraits. Yes, the first color was that card reuse, PC989, the green. Then I did the deco yellow, and now I'm busy with the cream, if any of you missed it. Yes, it's the list of colors is in the description. Thank you, Laura. beginning, were you ill? Oh, this one is Beige Sienna PC1080. Hi, Brandy. Yes, lots of colors. Yes, you must please rest. If it makes you feel better, then rest, Kenny. Hi, Kimmy. Next is Chestnut PC1081. Hi, Angela. Welcome. Hi, Nena. Yes, greens are mostly used on lighter skin, to give it some warmth and glow, and it enhances the normal skin tone colors. And blues and purples is mostly used on darker tone, skin tone colors. And also on very pinkish, like almost like a real light colored skin, you will also use blue, but light blue or medium blue as an undertone. I don't think you need to use tanned paper. I've done most of my images on white before. I'm just using toned grey so that it's easier in the tutorials, so that you can see all the light colors. Otherwise, you won't be able to see where I put the white. Brandy, it should work exactly the same, because I also have done polychromos before, but it depends on the paper that the colouring book is printed on. And Berta, I don't press too hard. This is quite medium to light that I'm pressing here. Hi, Nichols. Hi, Shelley. Hi, Della. No problem. You're welcome to ask questions. And that's the best way to learn, is to ask questions. Okay, next, I'm going to use the Artichoke PC1098. The artichoke I'm only going to use on the one side of the face where the darker shadow is. But you can carry it through if you want to extend the shadow into the face completely. But for what I'm having in mind for this image at the end, I will not be extending it. But you may extend it to enhance your portrait. Yes, Shelley. The green undertones give the skin tones a warm, glowing feel once you cover it, and I just find that it livens it up. Otherwise, it will be all brown tones and not glowing at all. It just livens it up a bit. And if you really look at your hands, for example, where you're sitting at the moment, if you look at it carefully, you'll see where the veins are, it's bluey, greeny colors. In the shadow areas, it's browny, and there will be cream and yellowy tones to it. So a normal skin has got lots of colors in it. It's not just brown and a mid-tone brown and pink. I'm so glad, Shelley. I'm glad I've taught you something. No, if only that would work. Then I think we all should slap on some green tones. Yes, I think me too. I will also just look like Shrek. Brandy, yes, I've got two coloring books on Amazon that's available to buy from Amazon itself. It's Color My Dreams 1 and 2. I'm still busy on the next one that will also be sold on Amazon, but it's not there yet. It's only 1 and 2. Hi, Bria. But Amazon is printing it, so I'm not involved with the printing of it. So the quality of... I'm still waiting for my copy because our borders have been closed with the coronavirus. So I haven't received it as yet. So I don't know the quality of the paper. And this one is beige 997. I'm also wondering about that, Rhea. I think I must try and find out. It would be interesting to know. Next is Rosy Beige, PC1019. Bye, Tammy. Thank you for popping in. Hi, Kirsty. I'm using Strathmore toned grey paper, but as I said before, you can use any paper that you feel comfortable with. The only reason why I'm using the toned grey is so that the people can see in the tutorial the light colours, because to show white on white and where it goes, it's a bit difficult. Next is Salmon Pink, PC1001. Hi, Selena. Thank you, Kirsty. Next is Nectar, PC1092. And always concentrate on how the shadow falls. For example, here by the nose, you have to go over the bump and then down. So you must always keep the shape of the face in mind when doing your shadow areas. Yes, Color My Dreams 4, Brandy. Her name is Shona, this badge's name. Just need to sharpen my pencil quick. And this one is Blush Pink, PC928. Next is Burnt Ochre, PC943. The nostrils is always a tricky one. So let me just get the chestnut. Is it not? No. Let's go. Henna. PC1031. I'm going to use two colors. If you look at the nostrils and where the shadow area is, wait, let me just try and zoom in for you. Is it better like this? I'm drawing a line on the edge. I'm just darkening the shadow slightly around the nostril. Then here, at the nostril wing, or that's what I call it, I'm just darkening it slightly. At the bottom, very lightly, thanks, Iselina. Now here, at the tip of the nose, we need to darken it, but you keep a slight, a lighter area, which I'm going to lighten just now with different colors. So you shape the tip of the nose with the shadow. Space, a slight space. Let me see if I can zoom in a little bit more. Sometimes I do use models, and sometimes I just see a advert or something, and then I like the face, and then I would just draw it from memory. And sometimes I use inspirational photos that inspires me, and then you give credit to the photographer and the model. Okay, to do the nose correctly, I'm going to use more than one color, but I'll say each and every time that I use it. So I'm just taking them all out. And this. Okay, first, I'm going to use the Spanish Orange PC1003. Hi, Loretta. So the yellow is that little line that you left open. Then I'm going to go over that Spanish Orange with Deca Yellow PC1011. You see that separates the nostril from the shadow area. Okay, this was the Black Raspberry PC1095. I've just darkened the nostrils slightly. Now we need to do the tip of the nose. The tip of the nose, I would use Chestnut, PC1081. Thank you so much, Della. Next is Nectar, PC1092. I'm just shading in the shadow area. Now we still have to do this side of the nose. So that side we've added the yellow area of the nose because I've got light coming from the bottom. That's why that one is highlighted in yellow. Normally the nose there would be just a lighter shade that you're using, like a cream or something. So on this side I would use the Mineral Orange, PC1033. But this time it's going to be on the side, right on the edge of the nostril. Oops. This one is Black Raspberry, PC1095. Thank you, Kimmy. Next is Sandbar Brown, PC1094. I just need to shape the tip of the nose. So Nectar, PC1092. Next is Beige Sienna, PC1080. Brandy, I don't use solvents. I haven't used them before. I haven't tried them, actually. But I'm open to try them. We'll see. Maybe at a later stage, give it a go. Next is Light Peach, PC927. I'm just bringing back the light. Have you all tried your portraits with the colored lights as yet? Next is beige, PC997. Thank you so much, Nana and Iselina and Rain. But sometimes I think it would be crazy being in my mind. Iselina, I think it would be great with band pastels. Okay, to create a chin to look right, you have to highlight. Okay, as I said, my lightest side of the face is my right hand side. So I'm doing the light area. Then I'm going to do pink, blush pink, PC928. Thank you, Pam. Next is Peach, PC939. I'm extending the pink here at the bottom of the chin towards this side. The right side. I'm covering my shadow area of earlier with a peach. But I'm extending the pink with the peach. Okay, next is the burnt ochre, PC943. I'm just putting the shadow underneath the lip. And another shadow in the corner of the mouth, the mouth corners, and I'm doing a circular shape. Yes, she is quite new, Bam. This is one of the new ones that I drew. Beige Sienna, PC1080. What's next? I'm darkening the shadow area on this side, the left-hand side. No, I don't plan any pencils beforehand. It's just normal basics. The undertones I would know on the light and the dark colors, but normally I don't plan any colors beforehand. I just start and then change pencils as I go along. I need to get some light in the jawline. So the Spanish orange, PC1003. Putting glow in there. Oh, that's not nice to hear, Rebel, but it's good to hear that you're recuperating. Thank you, Nina. This one is Beige Sienna, PC1080. Next is Goldenrod, PC1034. And then Beige, PC997. Then Salmon Pink, PC1001. Thank you so much, Kenny. Beige, PC997. Then the beige sienna, PC1080. Seashell Pink, PC1093. Seashell Pink, PC1093. Yes, Loretta, you're quite right. To get a realistic skin, you do need to layer quite a lot of colors. Next is Nectar, PC1092. I need it to be a little bit more orange. Cadium, orange, PC118. Hi, Maritza. So nice to see you here. Next is Clay Rose, PC1017. Mad answer. I love makeup. I used to dance Latin American dancing on world championship level, so I love wearing makeup and I love makeup. Next is Pink PC929. And this one is not in the list. I need to add it afterwards. But that was before I got married, Maritza. Many, many moons ago. Burnt Ochre, PC943. Brandy, that's the list just for the face. For the skin color. Thank you, country girl. Rebel, are you from South Africa? Wait, maybe I've missed the thread here. Country girl, I'm from South Africa. Yes. I'm from Cape Town, South Africa. Next is dark brown PC946. The color that I was using that was not on the list, Abby, was pink, the PC929. Next is goldenrod PC1034. See how the colors have changed? You can't even see all the green that we've put on the first layer. Yes, we're from all over the world and coloring is uniting us. Isn't that just amazing? Country girl, you can always play it back. It will be on the channel after I'm done. It will probably appear a little bit later. I find it only appears later on the channel, but it will be there, so you can just watch it back if you want. This one is chocolate PC1082. I'm not going to use that one any further. Oh, thank you so much, Color Me Pink Monkey. Thank you for the support. PC948 Sepia. Now, Peach PC939. Hi, Kat. Yes, it's also late here. Yes, Laura's from America, and Nikki Burnett's also from America. There's a couple of them that's from America. Thank you, Shell. This one is burned ochre, PC943. Next is Nectar, PC1009-2. Yes, I agree with Maritza. I love Laura's books and her live streams. She's absolutely brilliant. She's the one that actually got me starting on YouTube. Bye, cuz. This one is burnt ochre, PC943. And dark amber, PC947. Yes, our figures looks terrible, Shelley. It's really terrible. And this one is Beige Sienna, PC1080. I'm just blending in the darker bits that I've put on the next to the bridge nose, the nose of the bridge, or the nose's bridge. Next is Beige, PC997. Why, Shelley, you mustn't be intimidated. You must just go for it. It's just normal images. It's there to have fun. And that's why all the tutorials is just a guide, so that you can have more fun. But your work is so amazing. You must just go for it. Pam, I'm only going to do the skin on this one. On this tutorial, it's only for the skin tone. And then you guys can tell me what you want next. Do you want a dark skin or eyes or lips, or what do you want me to do next? And then we can do it. Shelley, you're an amazing colorist. And Angela, you're also an amazing colorist. And as we're all still learning. I learn things every day. I think you're never too old to learn. So it's good if you can learn one thing every day. Yes, the very light skin, you are quite right, Maritza, is with the light blue and the purples and the shadow areas, it's quite correct. Next is Clay Rose, PC1017. So what would you ladies like to learn next? Dark skin. Yes, there's quite a lot that one can learn from dark skin, from skin tones. There's dark skin, there's olive skin, there's the Indian skin. There's lots of different skin tones. And even with the lighter skin tones, you've got the really white, you've got the tanned. So there's quite a lot that one can learn from skin tones. Yes, can you believe she was green? This one is Tuscan Red, PC937. We're still building up the layers. Next, I'm going to use Peach PC939. Next is Nectar PC1092. Hi, Fairy Girl. Yeah, just go for it, Shelley. I know you will be great colouring the image. And you too, Nana. Just go for it. I would love to see your images. Shelley, a trick if you want to do lots of layers is hold your pencil in the back so that basically it doesn't matter how hard you push, you can't put the layer down too thick or too hard. So that's the one cheat way of handling or applying lots of layers. Bye, Shell. Thank you for popping in. And thank you for being here. If you feel like you're losing control of the stroke, then hold it in the middle of the pencil and then just try not to press downwards and rather do a side action shading like I'm doing here with the lilac PC956. Meredith, I don't use a blender because I use so many layers. If you look at the moment closely, you'll see that it's not smooth at all. The more layers I apply, then it smooths out completely. So that's, I think, maybe the main reason why I don't use a blender. Next is Mineral Orange PC1033. Next is Blush Pink PC928. Next is Light Peach PC927. Oh, Brandy, did you like the steampunk one with the pink hair? Would you like me to show you how I did that one? I think we can do that. Thank you so much, Abby. Next is burnt ochre, PC943. Meredith, I'm sure you will. Thank you, fairy girl. Sheila. Hello, Helen. Beige Sienna, PC1080. This one is henna, PC1031. Bye, Angela. Thank you for popping in. Next is Nectar, PC1092. Thank you, Pubs. Spanish Orange PC1003. Brandy, I'm really bad with that. I only use sharp pencils really for hair and for details like eyes and mouth. I don't on skin really sharpen my pencils. This one is Artichoke, PC1098. Okay, next is Cream, PC914. Okay, next is Pale Sage, PC1089. Now, just like with the colored lights portraits, where the powder blue gives you a whiter white than what white can give you. In skin tones, because she's got a green undertone, your pale sage would give you a very light, almost white-like highlight. Thank you, Shannon. Now I'm just going to warm up a bit with a little bit of yellows or yellow tones. I'm going to use Jasmin PC1012. Thank you, Nana. Next is the Great Lavender, PC1026. And then the Peach Beige, PC1085. And now I'm just blending most of the colors in. Next is Nectar PC1092 to blend the darker colors in. Around the nose. Next is Palmer Violet PC1008. Next is Clay Rose, PC1012. Next is Beige, PC997. Hi, Selena. So glad to see you here. Clay Rose, PC1017. Next is Burnt Ochre, PC943. Next is Dark Amber, PC947. Selena, your hair on yours is just outstanding. I love the color that you chose to do the hair. Yes, me and Selena's coloring this one together. Goldenrod PC1034. Next is Nectar PC1092. Next is Deca Peach PC1013. Next is Sandbar Brown, PC1094. Next is Burnt Ochre PC943. I will be so glad if you try Prismas again, Selena. And I'm so glad that I can make you use them again. Next is Nectar PC1092. Bye, Shelley. Have a great evening. Thank you for popping in. Really appreciate it. Next is Seashell Pink, PC1093. Next is Mineral Orange, PC1033. Next is Pink, PC929. Beige Sienna, PC1080. Next is Dark Brown, PC946. Thank you, Pam. Next, Sandbar Brown, PC1094. Next is Peach, PC939. And that's it for today. Can you believe she was green when we started? Thank you so much for watching, all of you. I think we can do a one-page giveaway quickly on a number calculator. Everybody can choose a number between 1 and 100. It's my pleasure. I'm so glad you guys were watching. Thank you for being in the live chat. And you're welcome to ask questions. You can choose a number between 1 and 100. then we do a page giveaway. Bye, Pam. Thank you for popping in and thank you for watching. Okay, everybody's number is in. Okay, the winning number is 8. Congrats, Abby! You won a page. You can go to my Etsy shop and you can choose any page you want, and then I'll email it to you. And I just want to thank everybody for watching today, and thank you to Laura for being my mod. And thank you so much for all the support from you guys. Thank you, Kenny. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye. Have a great evening or day. Bye-bye.